Welcome to another edition of the Carolina Bay of the Day. In this episode, we will discuss a Carolina Bay in North Carolina that is 200 meters above sea level and about 200 kilometers from the Atlantic coast. It is hidden in plain sight. You cannot see it in aerial views or in satellite images. Its elliptical geometry only becomes apparent when the terrain is viewed with LiDAR, which is a laser ranging technology. I received an email from Chris Cottrell that said, "Hey Tony, I have a special request for a Bay of the Day video about a Carolina Bay I stumbled across with my students earlier today. I think it has all the characteristics everyone needs to see and is one of those outlier Piedmont bays that has multiple street view angles and includes a road cut rim. Thanks and take care, Chris." Chris is a science educator who has a YouTube channel called Dabbler's Den, where he discusses the Carolina Bays and other topics. In 2019, Chris and I participated in a research excavation of a Carolina Bay organized by George Howard. We obtained some soil samples of the layers, and Chris and his students have helped to process them for analysis. This basin has all the typical attributes that characterize a Carolina Bay. It is elliptical with raised rims, and it is oriented toward the Great Lakes. The orientation is important because the glacier ice impact hypothesis proposes that the Carolina Bays were created by oblique secondary impacts of glacier ice chunks ejected by one or more extraterrestrial impacts on the Laurentide ice sheet. A satellite image of the same area shows some plowed fields and tree groves, but hardly any trace of the Carolina Bay. The terrain on which this bay is found is very hilly, but as we zoom in on its location, we can see that the bay is on a small flat area of the landscape. Carolina Bays are sandy structures that are easily eroded on uneven terrain. From the colorized topography of the LiDAR image, we can tell that the rim of the bay is 2 to 3 meters higher than the center of the bay. I selected 11 points along the perimeter of the bay and fitted them with an ellipse by the least squares method. All the points are on the ellipse, and the fit demonstrates that this Carolina Bay has a mathematically elliptical geometry. The bay has a length of 727 meters and a width of 518 meters. The azimuth of 130.5 degrees points just west of Lake Michigan, which after adjusting for the rotation of the Earth should correlate with the point from which the ice chunk that made this bay was launched. The ballistic trajectory of the ice projectile would have had a flight time of 8.4 minutes and reached a height of 313 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. It was a suborbital space flight in the vacuum of space. Ellipses are conic sections, and this implies that this Carolina Bay originated as an inclined conical cavity or penetration funnel. This is compatible with experimental results of ice projectiles striking a viscous target. A viewer of one of my past videos admonished me by saying, "Elliptical surface features are consistent with conical cavities, but utterly fail to imply conical cavities. Please do not express this falsehood again." It is not my intention to express falsehoods. My statements are based on experiments showing that oblique impacts of ice projectiles on a viscous surface produce inclined conical cavities with overturned flanges that become shallow elliptical basins with raised rims after viscous relaxation. When viewed from above, the inclined conical cavities look elliptical. These experiments are small, but they demonstrate the laws of physics. There's nothing false about it. These experiments provide a credible, reproducible, and scalable mechanism for the formation of the Carolina Bays, and you can conduct similar experiments yourself. The mechanisms shown in my experiments are described in the book Impact Cratering, a Geologic Process by Professor J. Melosh. The section about viscous degradation of craters says, "Simple and complex craters are the immediate result of impact crater excavation and collapse. However, long after these rapid events have occurred, craters on most planetary bodies continue to change and degrade toward the ultimate limit of gravitational stability, a level plane." The viscous relaxation process is illustrated in an image that shows a cavity decreasing in depth from the bottom up. Regarding the scalability of the physical model, Professor Melosh writes, "The physics of excavation is nearly the same for both microcraters and larger craters. The main difference is that target strength dominates the excavation of microcraters, whereas gravity plays the dominant role for most geologically important craters." Returning to our Carolina Bay, we see that the rim of the bay is crossed at 4 points by 2 roads. We can examine the surface features at the north, east, south, and west crossings using the street view feature of Google Maps. Samarkand Road crosses the north rim of the bay. The street view shows that the rim gently bulges about 1 meter above the road. Route 211 crosses the east rim of the bay. The LiDAR image shows the drainage ditch crossing under the road. This is exactly what we see in the street view. Samarkand Road also crosses the south rim of the bay. In this street view, the camera is facing north, and we can see that the road, which is on the rim of the bay, is slightly higher than the field to the right, which is the center of the bay. Road 211 crosses the west rim of the bay. The LiDAR image shows the road cutting through the rim. The street view shows a cross-section of the raised rim on both sides of the road. If you visit the area to look at these Carolina Bay rims, you may want to stop at the fruit stand in the middle of the bay at the intersection of Samarkand Road and Route 211. This presentation emphasizes the importance of using LiDAR images for doing research on the Carolina Bays. There is a mathematically elliptical geological feature hidden in plain sight in this landscape. But you cannot see it until you turn on the LiDAR visualization. Thank you for joining me in the investigation of the Carolina Bays and the Younger Dryas Cataclysm. There's a link to the LiDAR visualization tool in the description of the video. I will continue to examine the mechanisms that made the Carolina Bays based on the principles of experimental physics. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays and other scientific topics.